In this video, we're going to go through how to add multiple jobs to your GitHub Action workflow. In the previous video, we created this workflow here that has one job called build that has these steps. But sometimes you may want to have multiple steps to split up the work and organize it a different way. So let's walk through how you can actually do that. As mentioned, here we have our initial job that we built in the previous video. And to build another step here, it's as simple as adding another layer under this jobs component right here. So what I'm going to do is copy everything from the name of the job to the first step, just to keep the indentation. And under the last line here, I'm going to get all the way to the left and paste this in. And this time, instead of calling it build, let's just say we want to call it something else like display. We'll run this job using the same runner, this Linux Ubuntu latest runner. And in this case, we're just going to do something simple. We're not even going to worry about checking anything out. I'm actually going to do a run command, but what we'll do, we'll give this a name and we'll say print a value. Again, this is just an example to show you what a different job will look like. The actual steps I'm not too concerned about. And what we'll do is we'll use the run action and say echo hello from another job, save. Now I'm going to check this in and push it to our branch. This will go to our test CI branch. This is the one we're working in. And if you look at the on component of this workflow, we're saying when anything gets pushed to this branch, it'll run. So we should expect this to run. And here we do see it ran already completed, so it was quick. Now we have build. We can see all of these steps that were run. And then display just printed the value hello from another job, and it came through here and printed it. So just like that, we were able to split it up, and you can think about how you would want to do that. And one thing I'll call out here is if you go to summary, we see that these were run in parallel. They're not dependent on each other. When the job starts, it's going to kick off both of these at the same time, and there's no real relationship between these two or dependencies or anything like that. Let's talk about some things you could do if you wanted to make some sort of dependency between them. Maybe you want one to run first and then only run the second job once it's done. How would you do that? Let's take a look at the syntax here, the GitHub Action syntax. And what we're going to look at is this needs identifier. And it looks something like this. Really all we would add here is needs and then the name of whatever job you want it to be waiting for or dependent on. And that's it. It's as simple as that. In our case, we say jobs, and instead of job one, ours is called build, job two, display. If we want to change it so that display only runs once build runs, we would add something like this, needs build. And again, this means that it's only going to run after this one. Let's go ahead and commit that change and push it to now see what this looks like over here. We refresh, we see this is now here. And here, this now looks a little bit different. Right now we can see build is running and we only see build over here. This is all that's running so far. And then now this completed, it'll move on to display. Now display shows up here as well. And we can see this did not start until this build one finished. Pretty straightforward. Another thing to add here is if you had multiple jobs in a row that you wanted, let's say we had another one here, in this case, if job one and job two, you can create this span and say, this job three can only run once both of these are finished. So it'll depend on this one and this one, and it'll, like it says here, run in a sequential order, and you would see that one, two, three like this here. The last thing I want to call out is dealing with potential errors and whether or not you want a dependent job to run if one before it failed. Let's say there's a scenario where you have these dependent on each other. So display is dependent on build, but if build fails, you still want display to run. Currently, if this is dependent and this one fails, this is not going to run. But if you do want that to still run, you can use this if always condition here. It's a conditional expression so that it always runs regardless of whether they're successful or not. So let's test this out. Let's say it still needs it, but we'll add this if always condition. And what we'll have to do here is find a way to purposely error this. So let's do something like this, because this file doesn't exist. So I'm hoping that this will actually fail this job, but this would still run. So go ahead and push that up and let's see what this looks like. we would expect this to fail, because I'm assuming it's going to fail because it won't be able to find that file because it doesn't exist. And there it failed, but yet this one is still running. We can see this failed, you know, doesn't exist. And this one ran no problem, successful, and we were all good. That's just another subtlety about these dependencies that you can do if you wanted to. And that'll do it for this video. Hopefully you found this helpful. And if you did, please feel free to like the video, subscribe. I'll be uploading videos every week on similar topics, and I'll see you at the next video. Thanks for watching.